The eGauge can be configured to collect data from a variety of remote devices, including both third-party devices and other eGauges. In this video, we will cover adding a remote eGauge. For information on adding third-party devices, please see our documentation on third-party device integration. First, navigate to the installation page. Under Remote Devices, select Add Device. The device name does not affect where data is pulled from, but should make sense for your installation. Next, select Edit. This opens the Protocol and Device Address fields. The protocol selection depends on the type of connection between the two eGauges. If the devices are connected to the same network, UDP is the recommended protocol. In this instance, the device address would simply be the device name, for example, eGauge 12345. If UDP communication is not available, TCP communication may be used. In this instance, you must use the entire device address, for example, eGauge12345.d.eGauge.net. Once the protocol and device address have been configured, click the gray question mark. If the remote eGauge can be accessed, the question mark will change into a green check mark. Otherwise, it will change into a red X. Once a remote device is added, registers can be imported from that device. Create a new register and name it as needed. Next, select the P dropdown and select your remote device name from the list. Another dropdown menu containing the registers on that device should appear. Select the appropriate register. Note that each time the installation page is loaded, the gray question mark will need to be clicked before new registers can be imported from a remote device. Also, note that imported registers start recording from the time they are added. It is not possible to request historical data. Finally, each imported register consumes a physical register slot on the recording device.